Welcome to the Baku City Circuit, where...
No chance of rain now. If the situation changes, we'll let you know. Have set us back a little. Okie-dokie, we like to get a tire wear program done on at least one compound during these sessions. We can get some good strategy and development information, so it's worth the effort. Sebastian is in P1. Sebastian sat in P1. We're seeing minor damage to the front wing. Be easy on the car till we get it repaired. We don't... to spend time repairing the damage to the car.
was a big one. Confirm you're okay, please.
Set us back a little.
Quick look at the classification at the end of the session then. Here are your top three. Vettel, Wehrlein and Nico Rosberg. Thank you for joining us for free practice today. Welcome to qualifying in the Republic of Azerbaijan. The teams are making their last-minute adjustments before the lights go green, and the fight for pole position can...
We don't think you'll have any trouble getting into the next session, so don't push too hard. had to spend time repairing the damage to the car. session changes, we'll let you know.
Grid is all set then for the race tomorrow. But before we go, let's quickly remind ourselves of our top three, who are Hamilton, Massa, and Nico Rosberg. Goodbye for now then, but we're really just getting started. Make sure to join us again. Who would have imagined in those pioneering days of motor racing just how far and wide the love of speed and competition would spread? From Brands Hatch to Jerez to Valencia, the European Grand Prix has made its home all across the continent. And now a new era of this storied race brings us here, to the edge of the Caspian Sea. With 20 turns and a length of 3.7 miles, Baku City Circuit in the heart of the Azerbaijan capital is a real test of a driver's endurance, patience and precision. 90-degree corners through Sector 1 lead into a tightening uphill sprint as we start to circle around the old city. Then a 1.4 mile chase flat out through Sector 3 towards the finish line. As the drivers complete their preparations, down below us on the grid, one man who's no stranger to the pre-race pressure is Anthony Davidson, who joins me in the commentary box today. Great to have you with us, Ant. I'm sure you can tell us all about what goes through a driver's head before lights out.
But from the moment qualifying's over, you start to feel the adrenaline in your body build up and the buzz in your stomach as you anticipate the rundown into turn one. It's all a bit like going into battle. The unknown situation makes you nervous. Those pre-race nerves are a good thing. The day you don't have them means that you don't care anymore. And of course, you have to make sure that all the procedures are second nature to you so that they're not taking up too much of your capacity.
We've had some bad results recently. The pressure's on. Let's get it together today and remind them why you're number one.
Well then, after an exciting qualifying session yesterday, let's take a look at how the cars line up. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position. A very happy Felipe Massa starts second. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Rosberg, Vettel, Valtteri Bottas, and Alonso, Kvyat, Perez, Sainz, and a Ferrari. Button, Harry Anto, Nico Hülkenberg, and Ricciardo, Grosjean, Palmer, Marcus Ericsson, and Pascal Wehrlein, Magnussen, and Gutierrez, Felipe Nasser, and Max Verstappen completes the grid. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track.
GPS is now enabled and will be available to use when you are within 1 second of the car ahead in the DRS zone. We're considering switching to an alternate strategy. Do you want to change or stick to plan A? Softs. The time last lap was a 1 minute. The safety car is out. The safety car is out. We need to form up at a reduced pace. Keep a close eye on that delta time. Make sure to keep it positive. Drop your speed. Our delta is too low and we risk a penalty. Slow your pace immediately.
Thank you.
safety car.
Worse.
back up to speed. Fantastic drive, just fantastic. You deserved that race win.
Great effort there from Ferrari to take the victory today. And I have to wonder, Anthony Davidson, just what set them apart from the competition here?
Without a doubt, the safety car changed everything today. The key to their success was keeping calm and reacting to the situation quickly. We've seen teams in the past throw away wins because they were too hesitant, but here they were decisive and that's allowed them to take the advantage.
And as we can see, it's time for the podium, and as the drivers make their way out, there's a familiar red suit making its way to the top step. Fantastic win for Ferrari. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. Sebastian Vettel takes over the lead of the Drivers' Championship after that excellent result. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
It's a difficult call, but I'm going to have to give it to the Ferrari driver. That was a commanding performance today. Very impressive indeed.
On to the constructors then. We saw a dip in form from the championship leaders today. Their lead has taken a significant blow. Another team that excelled today was Williams, who make further progress up the table. It was great having you with us for this weekend. I hope you enjoyed it as much as we did. Until next time, though, goodbye.